will talk about different types of CASE available, CASE tools which is available. So what comes to your mind when someone asks you what are the top three tools that are used in CASE? Top three tools are Redis, EHCAS and Memcas. These are the widely used, most popular Redis CASE, EHCAS and Memcas. So we'll see what it is first and then we'll see the difference as well. So to get the authentic information, I am on redis.io, which is the official site of Redis, which says Redis is an open source in-memory data structure to store, which is used as database as well, database CASE and message broker. Redis provides data structures such as strings, hash set, lists, list set, sorted set with wide range of queries, bitmaps, hyperlogs, geospatial index and streams. Redis has a built-in replication, LRU vexin, transactions and different levels of on-disk persistence and provides high availability via Redis Sentinel and automatic partitioning with Redis cluster. The latest version is 6.2.4. You can download it from here. Now let's see what is ESCAS. It is for Java lovers. It is Java's most widely used CASE. EHCAS is an open source standard based CASE that boosts performance, offloads to database and simplifies scalability. It is the most widely used Java based CASE because it is robust, proven, full featured and integrates with other popular libraries and frameworks. EHCAS scales from in-process caching all the way to the mixed in-process or process deployments with terabyte sized CASE. Now if you are in Java, it requires Java 8 Plus. To get more details on this, you can visit ESCAS.org, which has docs ready to you, how you can get started, how you can embed it using Maven, the basic coding, how you can integrate it. These all are provided on its site. Now let's see the third popular tool, Memcas. Memcas is a free and open source high performance distributed memory object caching system, which is generic in nature but intended for use in speeding up dynamic web application by elevating database load. Memcas is an in-memory key value store for small chunks of arbitrary data such as strings or objects from results of database calls, API calls or page rendering. Memcas is very simple yet very powerful. Its simple design promises quick deployment, ease of development and solves many problems facing large data caches. Its API is available for most popular languages. Now let's see some differences as well. First let's see the difference between Redis and EHCAS. Redis is a shared data structure, while EHCAS is memory block storing serialized data objects. Redis is a shared data structure means you can put some predefined data structures such as string, list, set, etc. in one language and retrieve it in another language. This is useful if your project is multilingual. For example, if your project has Java as backend and PHP as the front end side, you can use Redis for shared CASE. But it can only store predefined data structures. You cannot insert any Java objects if you want. If your project is only Java, that is not multilingual, EHCAS is the convenient solution. Developers describe EHCAS as Java's most widely used CASE. EHCAS is an open source standard based CASE for boosting performance, offloading your database and simplifies scalability. It is the most widely used Java based CASE because it is robust, proven and full featured. On the other hand, Memcas is detailed as high performance distributed memory object caching system. Memcas is an in-memory key value store for small chunks of arbitrary data from results of database calls, API calls or page rendering. EHCAS belongs to CASE category on the tech stack, while the Memcas can primarily classify it as databases. EHCAS and Memcas both are open source tools. Now, since we looked at in detail what is Redis, what is EHCAS and what is Memcas, we have made separate video for Redis CAS in detail and we'll make the programming video how to integrate Redis, Memcas and EHCAS. So in the difference, what is the difference between all these three and what it is? So EHCache is widely reported JavaCache with tiered storage options, whereas memcache is in-memory key value storage originally intended for caching, and Redis is popular in-memory data platforms, data platform used as a cache, message broker as well, and database that can be deployed on-premises across clouds and hybrid environment as well. Now all these three are key value stores: EHCache, memcache, and Redis. Now you can see the ranking here. The overall ranking of EHCache is 76, memcache is 30, and Redis is just 6. The website of EHCache is ehcache.org. The official website of memcache is memcache.org, and for Redis we have two: redis.io and redislab.com. All these three have provided technical documentation as well, and you can find it on GitHub as well. Now, initial release of EHCache was in 2009, memcache in 2003, and Redis is 2009. So memcache is one of the oldest one. Now the implementation language of EHCache is Java, and memcache and Redis is built in C. All these are schema free, as we have seen in the description. And what are the languages that these are using which we can integrate? EHCache can be integrated using Java, but with memcache you can integrate it using Java, C, C++, .NET, Perl, lots of languages. And Redis is widely acceptable with most of the programming languages which is available, like C, C++, Java, Go, R, Python, everything, PHP, Pascal, everything. You can visit dbengines.com. You can visit this URL to see the detail of the differences between these. Okay, so there is no foreign key concept in any of these. Concurrency is supported by all these three. Durability is reported by EHCache and Redis, but not memcache. So we have seen the difference between EHCache, memcache, and Redis today. So if you think the video is helpful, please like the video and subscribe the channel. We are trying to make small videos, intro videos for many topics. And if you want to have any topic on our channel, if you want us to make any video on any of the particular topic, please write in the comment box. Thank you so much, viewers.